Madam Speaker, we, the Arizona delegation, rise today to honor the life of one of our own, one of our young, and one of our very best. Kayla Jean Mueller of Prescott, Arizona, was a young woman full of youthful exuberance, optimism about peace and humanity, and willing to put her life on the line to help others halfway around the world. Kayla stood as a beacon of light and hope in a time that is too often filled with darkness. She was a beautiful soul, and I know she is with God now. And while all of our hearts are heavy with sadness of Kayla's passing, we stand here unified and strengthened to carry on her spirit, courage, and compassion that has touched millions. We must endeavor to remain brave and strong in the face of those who wish to terrify, just as Kayla did. No parent should ever have to endure the pain and suffering of losing a child so early. But now, let us look back fondly upon her life and the many ways she made our lives better by the words she spoke. I find God in the suffering eyes reflected in mine. If this is how you are revealed to me, this is how I will forever seek you. I now acknowledge the gentlewoman from Arizona, Ms. Kirkpatrick.
We're here today to honor Kayla Mueller and her courage and undying spirit and determination. And we're here to offer our hearts and prayers and comfort to her grieving family and friends. In Arizona, in Flagstaff, and in Prescott, we're all neighbors and we're all friends. Kayla went to Northern Arizona University, which is in my hometown, Flagstaff. And talking to her friends and her professors, everyone talks about her dedication to serving others. Even if it meant going to far away places that were dangerous, she was driven by a compassion to help the suffering. We know that her short life is proof that one dedicated soul can touch 1,000 others. Let us all keep Kayla's family in our prayers and her legacy in our hearts. And I yield back.
I now ask the House to join my colleagues and me for a moment of silence in honor in the immortal spirit of Kayla Mueller. Thank you, Madam Speaker.